Yeah, this is actually a thing now. What's going on, everyone? Back with another episode of Stuff and Things. And this is going to serve as my spring
everyday carry update. Yeah, this is legit a thing now, which I'll talk about in a second. All right, so as you guys know, I've been doing my everyday carry updates in about 3 month increments. So I was supposed to do the spring one on April 15th, which was last week, which was lockdown knife week. So it got pushed back a little bit. The summer one will be coming out July 15th or somewhere around that date. So we're still on track. Now this video is going to be a little bit weird because as you guys know, times are a little bit different than they were even 3 months ago when I did my winter update. Because the times have changed, there are two things that are not typically in my everyday carry. However, they are now because they almost have to be. Another thing that's going to be a little bit weird is that I'm going to be making two sort of like secret announcements. This is something that I really didn't want to do because I like keeping things under wraps until I can actually release something and explain it all to you guys, but we'll cross that bridge in a second. So, everyday carry, what has been on my person, in my pockets, and with me throughout my life. Starting up here in my front right pocket, still carrying the same cell phone, the iPhone XS Max. It's the iPhone 10. I now have it in a really slim case because I don't leave the house a whole lot, so it's like not very protective, but it keeps the phone nice and slim. Still rocking the pop socket. The reason I'm using this like lesser protective case is because I'm not out walking around on concrete, we got carpet. I'm not as worried about dropping and breaking my phone, so that's just what I have it in right now. Another thing that typically pairs with that is my Apple Watch, which I'm not wearing because I'm not really exercising or leaving the house a whole lot. When I'm out and about, I typically like to have that watch on so I can see like how far I'm walking and things like that, but that's not the case anymore. So as of right now, I'm not really wearing a watch. Another thing that never really changes, my belt. Still rocking the best belt ever. This is my collab with Travax. It's a Travax cinch. You guys have seen this a million times and that has not changed at all. Also coming from Travax, I went from the Summit wallet back to the Contour, and this is my branded Contour. This is the wallet that I always go back to. And here I do have the Travax Shift to get my beard in order after I'm done wearing that mask. And this is really a mainstay in my EDC. This is hands down my favorite wallet coming from Travax, or favorite wallet ever, I should say. Now, speaking of the mask, I guess we'll talk about this stuff right now. Because of everything going on in the world, just today, actually, as I'm filming this video, masks are mandatory when you are out in public now. I'm gonna try to talk about this without getting too political because I obviously have some feelings about it, which are besides the point, but I wanted to kind of see what this was all about. This morning I went to a gas station down on the corner to pick up a drink and there were actually signs that said, face masks are required. I had this one on, I walked in, grabbed my drink and that was it, paid for my stuff and walked out. While I was doing that, another guy walked in behind me without a mask on, and the people at the counter legit told him that he had to leave the store. They stopped him in his tracks, they came out from behind the counter and said, "I'm sorry, sir, you have to leave," which is just like crazy. So anyway, with these new rulings, you have to have a face covering, and this is one of my best options right now. It's crazy because these businesses are going to basically accept anything. You could tie a bandana around your face and that would be fine. The only thing that in some cases is like debatable would be the effectiveness of an N95 mask or some type of like surgical level mask. This thing is a little bit better than just like a piece of cloth covering my mouth. This is coming from JMO Threads. They sent me this like a long, long time ago. I believe it was one of my first or second mail time videos when that actually became like a series here on the channel. And this thing was actually designed with these little replaceable masks inside of here. And the purpose of this is actually for air pollution and smoke and any type of small particulate. It's good for filtering air. However, this is not going to filter out anything that could cause sickness. I think something like this is better than just like having cloth like this over your face. It is a little bit difficult to breathe in, and it's just obviously super inconvenient. But without this, I wouldn't be allowed to walk into stores now, which is still insane to me. So this has now become a part of my EDC. I do have some different masks, so I can actually pull these off and replace them. I can wash this if need be. And I actually ordered some other face coverings, which I'm going to have to start using, I guess. Really hope this ends soon. Going along with that, right up here, you may have seen this clipped on my belt, hand sanitizer. This is something that might actually just stay in my EDC because it's always good to keep yourself clean, including your hands. So I clip that onto my belt. I don't wear gloves when I'm out in public because I think a lot of people are doing this stuff and they're causing more of an issue. PPE, especially gloves, are made to not cross-contaminate. So when people aren't experienced with this stuff, they're putting gloves on when they leave the house, they're still going about their lives touching everything and getting in their car and driving around, and they're spreading this stuff just on their gloves now. That's not the purpose of gloves. Again, I really don't want to get into this a whole lot, but people, I think, should do a little bit more research on what gloves are actually used for and how you should be wearing gloves when you're out in public during times like this. In most cases, it's safer to just not wear gloves and carry around hand sanitizer like this. If you're too lazy to do research, that is actually what I would recommend. It is just super simple and it works. So use this stuff. Don't like dry it off either. Put a good amount on your hands, and I'm not here to tell you guys how to live your life, whatever. So that is a weird part of this EDC update now, and I guess that's all for now. So now we're getting into the two things that are like sort of a preview, but I didn't want to do it this way. First up, we'll take a look at my keys, where not a whole lot has changed. I'm still rocking the Travax Link here, quick detach lanyard. These are the keys to my Subaru. Since my road trip has been postponed a little bit, I'm driving my Crosstrek once again. The van is being used when I'm going up into the mountains and things like that. However, I'm not in there full time. I still have the little Olight keychain. This is the I1R EOS, rechargeable. Love this thing, super inexpensive. You can get them on Amazon. And now you will notice that I do not have something on here. If you're an avid watcher of all of my EDC updates, I typically have a Gerber Shard on here. Now, a few EDC updates ago, I mentioned that there is one thing that I really don't like about the Gerber Shard, and I wanted to kind of fix that. So I'm currently in the works now of developing my own tool to replace that Gerber Shard. I've teamed up with a company to make this come to life, and we are in the prototype phase now. I actually typically have the prototype on here. I removed it for now because I can't actually show anything yet. So I apologize that I can't show you guys this, but this is something that is going to be coming hopefully sooner than later. With everything in the world that is going on right now, supply chains have changed a lot, and a lot of things that were supposed to happen are either being canceled or postponed. So because of that, these tools that we are developing are not going to be available as soon as I hoped. However, it's a lot sooner than it was 3 months ago. I'm excited to show you guys this tool that we've been working on though, and hopefully by my summer update, they will be available to purchase. So more on that coming soon. That about wraps it up for my keys. Now for my pocket knife. This is one that I received just after I finished filming the Lockdown Knife Week, so there is no dedicated video on this blade. And for the past week or so, this is one that has been in my pocket just because it's new, and whenever I get a new knife, I tend to crush on it a lot. Super cool. It's the Arcform Slimfoot. Now this is a collaboration between the owner and designer of Tough Knives. He designed this with Arcform, and they're produced by ProTec, so it has a ProTec action. It's like a big mashup of different people here making this thing come to life, and I dig it a lot. So this is a black coated 154cm blade. It's sort of like a Wharncliffe sheep's foot design. So for everyday carry tasks, I think this is a really cool shape. It's a pretty small knife. It's about the same size as the Benchmade Bug Out because that's an increasingly popular knife right now. And then everything else about it is super sleek and simple. The pocket clip on here is great. It's actually recessed into the handles. That way this thing is easy to slide in and out of your pocket. There's no texturing on here, which is something that I actually find that I'm liking now. For an everyday carry knife, I don't need a whole lot of crazy aggressive texturing, and I'm just opening boxes and letters and things like that. This knife has been great for that. The centering is perfect, the push button is really nice, and like I mentioned, this was manufactured by Protech, so it has that super nice thwack of the Protech action. I love this knife a lot. So that is the blade for now. That's something that has been changing quite a lot because of Lockdown Knife Week. Before, I was on the Para 3 lightweight, and then I moved to the Sebenza 31, and then during the knife week, I was just carrying like whatever I was reviewing that day. Now I moved on to this, and I think I'm also kind of interested in carrying the Bug Out. I am looking forward to hopefully getting my hands on the CF Elite version of that knife, and I think I'm gonna like that a lot too. So maybe if I get my hands on that, it will replace this, but for now, the Arc Form will be found in my pocket. And now finally, the firearm that I've been carrying. This is another thing that I unfortunately cannot show you guys. I will, however, explain a lot more about what's going on and why I haven't shown this, because things have been delayed once again because of everything going on in the world. So yes, I'm still carrying my 43X in this holster right here, coming from QVO, and this is one of their new single clips. So this is their more discreet holster, and it's now using this single-sided clip here where you get the retention points. I've found that I like this a lot more. It's a little bit more sleek and minimal. Same black multicam Kydex on there, and I'm really digging this setup right here. I am carrying my 43X with some Federal HSTs, and this is a 15-round metal mag coming from Shield Arms. I've been testing this out quite a bit, and so far it's been reliable for me, so I do trust this, and this is actually the magazine that's in my gun every single day. Now for the gun itself. Everyone wants to know what it looks like and what I've done to it and why can't I show anyone. So I've taken my 43X and I've customized it completely to my tastes and preferences. I'm talking everything. Designed it from the top down, starting with sketches on paper, designed a slide and changed some internal type of stuff, texturing, colors, different coatings, everything top to bottom. Now I planned on announcing this in a video that was supposed to drop the beginning of this month. However, with everything going on, that has been delayed, pushed back, and I don't want to wait any longer. So that just spoiled the whole surprise. There you guys go. People have been hounding me. They want to see photos of it. They want to see this and that. And unfortunately, that's why I can't show you, because it's not ready yet. I've been shooting, testing, and carrying my prototype version now. I have well over 1,000 rounds through that. And the gun is killer. I love it so much. I can't wait to actually release it and show you guys what it's all about. However, because of everything going on, this has been pushed back and I don't have a date on when I will make a video on it. I don't have a date on when you will even be able to see it. I don't know when they will be available for order. I can't even talk about pricing or anything yet. All of that stuff is under wraps, but that is what's going on. And I know this is going to piss people off who are gonna be like,
why don't you just show us? That's so lame.
You asked for it. I can't show the gun right now, so that is just what it is. I'm trying to think if there's anything else that I can mention about it, and I really don't think there is, but I'm really excited to share it with you all. So that is all for my really weird and secret EDC update for spring of 2020. I'm hoping by the July, the summer update, that a lot of things will have changed and I'll be able to show you guys these new products that I've been working on for a while. Hopefully I don't have to wear a mask and stick to these like crazy regulations that are going into place. And I hope everyone out there is doing well. Hope you guys are staying safe and healthy. Now, that's all that I have for today. So if you guys are new to this channel, consider clicking subscribe. I make new videos every single week. That's gonna be all. So as always, thank you for watching. And I will talk to you in the next one.